right, let's do this. It's gonna be a good one, y'all. No rules. All right, how's it going out there, people? It is Monday. It is 4 o'clock Eastern time, which means one thing. Time to haiku. And I, for one, am super pumped. You know why? Because normally I'm over here working. But today, ChatGPT is going to be working for us, people. That's right. Today, I'm playing Haiku Cyber Range, except I am Smart Hands. Let me get logged into the range here. I'm Smart Hands. And Haiku is going to be run by ChatGPT. And that's how we roll. Where are you at? Who's up in here? Shuttle Crab? I see you. Carrie, what's up in here? Jeff Fuller. Sean Spratt, 1 p.m. Seattle. That's right, 4 p.m. Eastern. You do you, boo. There we go. Get the ranges going. All right, so we're doing all sorts of stuff. What's up, my man Aaron Katz Gage? Yeager. What's up, Katz? Good to see you, man. Jeff Fuller's in here. Howdy, everyone. What's up, Alex? Guys, we are blowing out the copyright policies right off the rip. Got my water. My wife brought me a smoothie. We're ready. Guys, today, we are going into ChatGPT. We are going to Haiku's range. For those of you who don't know, ChatGPT, I don't know where you've been if you don't know about this, but ChatGPT is one of these OpenAI chatbots. You give it questions, it gives you answers. It's been hotly contested lately because it'll give you very confident answers, but it also doesn't know exactly what it's talking about. It's trained on models like all AI is, and it could give you something strong, it could give you something weak, and you wouldn't know. The good thing is I find that it's really, really useful if you already have some idea of what you're doing. If you have some instances or some idea of what you're doing, ChatGPT can help you kind of like do a lot of like lower level admin work, if you will. Haiku Pro, what is that? Haiku Pro, let me give you guys a little taste here. Haiku Pro here on the left is a cyber range. You can go to haikupro.com. I'll put a link in the chat below. Haikupro.com. It is ChatGPT versus Haiku Pro. Dude, I'm just going all in on the music today. Let's go, Andrew WK. All right, Lilo, what's up from the Netherlands coming in hot? Matthew Bruno, excited to see what happens. All right, guys, let's not mess around and get right into it. I've got chat up. I can see what you guys are doing. Let's get into it. First of all, can you guys see ChatGPT? Classic Echo. I asked Chatbot to ask me if Chatbot can see this. Oh, I see. My big head's in the way. How do we move my head? How's that? Can you guys see Chatbot? Okay, cool. That's good. And obviously you can see the ranges. All right, so let's go in. You can see, guys, on Haiku Pro, I'm already logged in. If you have been playing Haiku Pro, then you are familiar with this. But for those who need a hot minute, a little orientation, Haiku Pro has a collection of cyber ranges. And as you can see here, the ranges have different levels of difficulty. They tell you the operating system that the range is at. One really interesting thing about Haiku Pro is that there are offensive ranges, your classic pen testing. There are defensive ranges, so think kind of SOC analyst type stuff. And then there are forensics ranges. So think of, you know, differ kind of analysts, get, you know, like getting into file carving, accessing data disk. Where the file system has been removed, but there's still, you know, data on the disk. How do you like realign that, carve it out, that type of stuff. Also on these cards, you can see that they give you a little bit of indication as to what lessons you'll learn on the range. So here you go, faulty system. You're doing SQL injection, web apps, working with frameworks. Bark gives you public vuln discovery. So this is what's going on. Now I wanted to do Silk Road today. I did want to do this before, but you guys know how I like to roll. I like to go YOLO and have my experience be what you're seeing, not some staged, you know, act or whatever. So we're going to be going all up in this thing, and we're going to see what happened. Is Jenny Housley in the house? I do need me some Jenny Housley in here. Oh, Chip, go to Simply Cyber. Chip, here you go, bud. You can go to Haiku's YouTube page. I don't know the link off the top of my head, but... I see Chip already made it in here. What's up? Casually Joseph, my man. Let's see. Casually Joseph, it's ChatGPT versus Cyber Range. So, guys, looking at this range, you can see that we're going to be doing Cali and Map. They have Agenda 21, which is a faction within the Haiku universe. A little Linux privilege escalation, Linux file system, John the Ripper. This is just your typical Thanksgiving Day smorgasbord buffet, right? This is a table of all the stuff we're going to be getting into it. So let's do it, right? What's up, Just a Bite? Good to see you. All right, let's play the range. Now, this is a full Kali box that we're going to be piloting inside of an environment that is the range. So Haiku Pro, when you do this, spins up the necessary workstations or endpoints or whatever with the proper configurations for the range and get it all set up. So you don't have to worry about configuring anything. You don't have to worry about any of that stuff. Oh, I love this guitar here. The bass. All right, let me find something really quickly. Dude, I love this album. Are you guys old enough to know this album? Hey, Chris Hidalgo, my man, what's up? Dude, I love this album. We might actually, this might just be a dookie. A dookie day. All right, as soon as this song's over, we'll do dookie. Okay, so the way that, all right, Chip, it is the best album, right, Roy? Oh, this album's sick, man. Okay, and it is one of those albums that playing it all the way through is awesome. Okay, so you can see here, this is the summary of the range. This is our Linux box. I just want to give you, like, orientate everybody to what we're doing. If we do take notes, we can do it down here. We have 1 hour to complete the range, and just so we all understand, you know, this is a full Linux Kali box, okay? So we're not messing about here. 94. Rich, 64. All right, guys. So the cool thing is, like any other kind of range CTF, let's do this correctly. So the cyber terrorist Lazar Group runs an illicit website known as the Silk Road. Notorious for selling drugs and other illegal items online, Lazar Group has harmed many people within your network. You, as a hacktivist, are determined to fight the Lazar Group. Even though you tried to inform the authorities, there's just too much red tape and bureaucracy is impeding success. So what are we going to do, Chip Harris? We're taking things into our own hands and exposing this syndicate. LFG. All right, so the first thing that we're going to do is gather information on the target to find an attack vector. Which ports are open? Okay. Hold on 1 second. We're going to do this whole album. All right. I don't have to worry about music for a while. Okay, so how does Chatbot work into this? So in my mind, what ports are open, okay? Now, you might have an idea of what we're going to type in here, but here, check it out. How do I tell what ports are open on a target machine, okay? Actually, I'll even say on a web server, since we do know that because of, here, can I move myself here? So we do know that it's a web server, and we know that we're looking for open ports, right? So with no ideas, let's see what we can do. There's a few different ways to check which ports are open on a web server. The Nmap utility is a popular tool for scanning networks and checking the status of network ports. You can use it to scan a specific host or range of hosts to see which ports are open. You can also use Telnet. Nice. All right, so check it out. Again, we all many of us here know what we're supposed to do, but I want to make this a ChatGPT stream. So we're gonna do this, okay? All right, so the first thing that ChatGPT says is Nmap. Okay, what is the Nmap, or how do I scan a web server's ports with Nmap? All right. Here we go. Doink. Thank you, ChatGPT. This will scan all of the ports on the server and report which ones are open. That sounds like something that we want. So, here. Okay, ChatGPT. Like, no one's giving out medals for try hard. Like, pump the brakes, dude. Like, Nmap's, I mean, ChatGPT's got a lot to say. God. Okay. How do you, like, send an interrupt request to this guy? He's an awfully chatty bot. Okay, so what I should have said is, how do I scan? How do I scan a web server at IP address 10.161.119.91? How do I scan a web server at for open ports with Nmap? All right, let's see. Control C, ChatGPT. Hey, Tyler, Black Navy Vet, good to see you. All right, so here you go. Look, we can copy this code. Like, chatbot, literally just put it in. All I'm gonna do is copy and paste this in here, okay? I have to use guacamole, which is this. Hold on, I gotta. All right, so we're just gonna go ahead and put that in there. Okay. All right, so we literally copied and pasted it from chatbot, okay? All right, and there's two ports. I'm gonna call this a win for chatbot GPT. Now, having said that, remember, chatbot also said you can use telnet, okay? You can use the command telnet IP port 80. If the port is open, you should see a blank screen with a cursor. Okay, so let's do this. Write a bash script to use telnet to iterate over ports 1 to 100 to see if a telnet server is listening. I don't even know if this is going to work. This is like the crazy part about chatbot GPT. Here's a simple bash script that will use telnet command to iterate over ports 1 to 100 and check if telnet server is listening. Oh, look, and ChatGPT remembered my IP address I suggested. Okay, guys, so check this out. This is awesome. Look at this. How many people we got up in here? 56 people. ChatBot GPT just wrote a bash script for me. Now, guys, listen. We used Nmap, and we got our answers. So we can get the flag. That the point is to see how much we can get chatbot to do all of the things. All right. So this is the bash script. So let's close this. Now let's do nano. Yeah, I'm a nano guy. If you're a VI person, you know, I don't know what to tell you. Check for open ports. .sh. What do you mean buffer's empty? There we go. All right, so here's our chatbot. Here, let me properly comment this. Written by ChatGPT. ChatGPT. Okay, let's exit. Okay, now let's run it, right? See, this didn't work. Okay, so check it out. It ran it, and it did it correctly. Now, what I want to see is, let's do this, because it's too noisy. So let's get rid of this command right here. Right? And can I do that? Okay, actually, I don't even know if I can do that. Let's do it this way. Just to be a brat. D's. I'll let you fill it in. All right, now let's run it. And they, like, you'll see the open ones stick out a little bit more. Port 80. Port 22. Okay? So we just solved the puzzle or the challenge in two different ways, all because, you know, using a chatbot to do all the work, right? We still don't know anything about anything. Let's just look at the third option here. Some web servers provide a tool or utility that allows you, what's Jared say? CHmon. All right, so some web servers provide a tool or utility that allows you to check the status of open ports. For example, Apache HTTP includes this. So this one doesn't work because we didn't explain to chatbot that we'd be scanning it remotely. We just wanted to see open ports. So this one is if you actually control the web server. This one says check the server's config files to see which ports are listed on. So neither of those work. But using the two options that did work, Nmap and Telnet, we were able to do it. And I want to point out that chatbot or ChatGPT wrote the terminal shell script. I mean, wrote a bash script in Telnet with comments and consideration for both situations in about 8 seconds. Okay, so let's go ahead. All right, here we go. Now, I've already done this range, so I'm not getting the points, but I hope you're enjoying this because I think it's wicked cool. Yeah, I might have Sniper Chip. I'm not familiar with Sniper. How does Sniper work? Actually, let me ask Chatbot. What is the cybersecurity tool Sniper? Let's see what ChatGPT says. He doesn't know it, or she doesn't know it. Yeah, John Hammond did tweet that. No ChatGPT. All right, so I don't see Sniper. Yeah, I don't see Sniper anywhere. Okay, so we got our first flag. Nice work, everybody. So next flag. Enumerate the available resources on the web server through directory brute forcing and see if there's any information we can leverage to obtain a low-priv foothold. What is the URL path for the directory with the data disclosure vulnerability? Okay, now let's pretend we don't know what we're doing. Enumerate the available resources on the web server. Check this out. How do I enumerate? I like just terrible, terrible text. Oh, we just violated content policy.
Call!
Hold on. ChatGPT does not agree. All right, here we go. We're getting some actual options, though. Dude, this album's so good. Yeah, Metasploit's on the box. Let's check. Yeah, there we go. Metasploit's spinning up. All right, so check it out. We're trying to, we're being asked to enumerate available resources on the web server, all right? Through directory brute forcing. ChatGPT says directory brute forcing is also known as directory discovery. 1 second. Okay. All right, so it's known as directory brute forcing, which is very cool. Or directory discovery, directory scanning. It's a technique used to enumerate available resources. This is mapping up to what the range is asking us to do. Access a large number of directories. Yeah. There are many tools available, including Dirbuster, Burp Suite, WFuzz. To use these tools, you need to specify a target web server. Okay, so what is the command to use Dirbuster to look to enumerate resources on 10.161.119.91. See if we can get an actual command here. Here we go. Well, I don't like that. So it's wanting me to use Java, a jar file, which I'm not going to do. Let's see if we can ask it to fix that. Because here, I'll tell you what, I will actually try that. I don't think, personally, I don't think that's going to work, but we'll try it. And then I'm going to ask it to use a Kali box command line instance, okay? Oh, yeah. On Akachi, it's Green Day all day long. Okay, so let's try this right here. I don't like this. I don't think this is going to happen. Also, here's one problem with ChatGPT. This right here is not going to work, right? This is informing the user to incorporate a path to the word list. This is not a directory on the box, okay? So let's do this. Just for discussion, right? I'm gonna go ahead and put this in here, and then two things are gonna go on. One, obviously, path to word list is gonna fail because that doesn't really exist. And then I don't think Java jar Dirbuster is gonna work because that jar is not in the local directory. So my guess is it's gonna say that it doesn't exist. Yeah, it doesn't exist, right? Unable to access that. So let's do this. What is this same command, but on a Kali Linux command line? And then let me just see, man Dirbuster. I really want to use Derby, but here. So I'm asking it for command line version of this. Oh, here we go. Using Dirbuster. Oh, Dirbuster is a graphical interface. I forgot about that. All right, so let's do what it says, okay? Let's follow this. Dirbuster. Let's see what it says. All right, we got a big ugly GUI. Here we go. All right, this will start Dirbuster, which will allow you to specify a target. To specify a target, enter the target in the URL. Okay. http://10.161.119.91. Okay, what else? To specify the word list, click the word list tab and use the add button. Okay. Where's the word list? Is this the word list? It doesn't say word list, but this is clearly where the word list goes. So we'll do that. Okay, so check it out. Let me also do this, because like I would say, okay, like you and I know where the word list is, but let's pretend we have no idea what we're doing. Where are Dirbuster word lists on a Kali machine? Or what directory, right? Because that's, it does say select the directory, right? So again, we're just looking at what's on the screen and trying to ask ChatGPT to answer this for us. So they say user share Dirbuster words list. All right, so let's do that. User share. Dirbuster word lists. All right. So let's do small and hope. Okay, here we go. Now, it says once you've got your word list, you can also specify additional options such as HTTP, GET, or POST, number of threads to use. Where's the advanced tab? I would love to have as many threads as possible. Can we do like a million threads? No? All right. Oh, crap. I can't, This box is too small. Shoot. I can't close this window because my resolution is... Shit. Shoot. Okay, you know what we got to do? This is why using graphical user interfaces is not optimal. This is not part of the demonstration. This is just reality of what we have to do. Have the time to listen to me whine. Okay, what I'm gonna do is kill the process that's running Dirbuster. Come on. Which one's the pit? It's this one, right? All right, so we killed Dirbuster. Not part of the demonstration. Nothing to see here. All right, so let's do Dirbuster again. Let's just do what the stupid direction said instead of trying to be all goofy here. All right, we're going to get our word list. Man, I lost my dreams. She says it's like a sex dream. All right, let's go. And two. All right, here we go. So now we're going to just hit start, right? Yeah, of course. Oh, I put HTTPS like a goober. Here we go. Now this gives us an opportunity to talk. Here. We can change the threads here. Let's do 100 threads. You see how the time to finish just went down? So this gives me an opportunity to talk to you guys. Hey, Jenny Housley, good to see you. Yeah, normally I would use just Derby, but yeah. We're grinding here. We're grinding. It's good to see you, Jenny. Oh, the max is 200? Jared Pierpoint wants me to turn the dial to 11. Let's do it. Ooh. What's up, James McQuiggan? Good to see you this afternoon. I'm using ChatGPT on the right here to break a cyber range on the left over here. Oh, ChatGPT is so good. Here, while we're waiting... Tell me a cybersecurity joke. See, let's get a joke in here. Why was the computer cold? Because it left its windows open. I don't have a haha. I don't have a haha, but let me fix that while we're doing this. I'm going to give this just another minute, and then I'm going to tell you guys what's up. How was everybody's New Year's? I hope you guys had a good New Year's. Mine was good. Had a Wii party. You guys remember Nintendo Wii? I had to actually go buy an RCA to HDMI converter because TVs made after like 2005 don't have RCA connections. ChatGPT will write a Chrome extension? I don't even know what like I'd even ask for. So ChatGPT's almost done. We're running 200 threads here. The problem with Dirtbuster, the GUI application, is that it's slow. You could run the same query with Derby in a substantially faster amount of time. Look at, we're using the 45, 50%. I feel like we could have gone to 500. Okay, so it looks like we've completed all of our Derb testing. And here are our results. Right? So Dirtbuster just enumerated all the resources. Remember, the query, just to take you guys back for a second, the challenge is to enumerate the available resources on the web server through directory brute forcing to see if there's any information that we can leverage to obtain a low priv foothold. We asked ChatGPT how to enumerate resources. It told us to use Dirtbuster. We asked, how do you use Dirtbuster? It gave us this Java command, it wasn't going to work. So then I said, tell me how to do it on a Kali box. And it said, use Dirtbuster and then put these things in these fields. And it successfully did it. Nicely done, everybody. So it looks like, here, let's do this. We're going to open a browser. We have a password and an email address. All right, let's go ahead and copy it. Just another cool thing that the Haiku Pro range has is the ability to take notes. So we're going to take a note and we'll just say, whatever, ChatGPT. And then we're going to paste our notes. Come on, why can't I paste my notes? Bro. All right, well, that's not working at the moment, unfortunately. Copy. Paste. All right, so it looks like we might have to paste that offline. In a different window. So give me a second. All right. Oh yeah, you guys can see I'm doing a full screen share. So I've got Notepad open and I've got some information. Now remember, we actually had user two also. So let's open that in a browser and see what we get. Something else here. User one at Crime Company, and a password. All right. So it's data users, right? So let's see. This is probably right. Nicely done, everybody. What's up, everyone? Eric the Gray's in the house. We got 67 people in here watching us take Haiku Pro down with ChatGPT. All right, so we're moving on to the password cracking and low proof foothold challenge. Let's see what Chatbot can do for us. Also, hold on one second before we move on. I just want to point out that ChatGPT gave us a couple options, including WFuzz. I've never used WFuzz. How do I use WFuzz to enumerate resources? I just want to see. To show you that you can use this for like multiple different applications. Okay. Now I'm just going to do this just as a quick little demonstration. Now the nice thing is guys, if you were doing cyber ranges to help educate yourself, hone your skills, kind of keep your axe sharp, this is really cool because not only does it give you the command, but then it gives you an explanation on why the command's doing what it's doing and examples. So if you were like, say you were boning up for a job interview or something, like this gives you the how and the why. So you're able to like really appreciate and understand the context of what you're doing. Exactly, Josh Mason. So John Boarding, it's funny you say that. OSCP officially announced that ChatGPT is not allowed. John Hammond tweeted that earlier today. So let's go ahead and use our code. All right, there's our command. Let's get rid of this. Oh, hold on. I gotta kill Durbuster. Okay. All right, so now our command's wfuzz-c file, path to word list, dash u HTTP. So it's taken our IP address for our target already, which is great. And then just for the save us all time, in the last exercise, we found the word lists. So, you know, I'm just going to assume that we know that information now, right? Is that, what am I doing wrong here? All right, I'm just doing this for the sake of ease. All right. All right, let's give this a shot and see what happens. All right, hold on. Something happened. Too many arguments? Hold on a second. I think it might be a hidden space here. Yeah, there it goes. Winning! So again, like ChatGPT tells us exactly what we need to type in. We could have no idea what we're doing. None. All we're doing is reading the range challenge and basically typing it in here. And ChatGPT has given us multiple options, multiple tools. Say you hop on a box and they don't have Durbuster installed. They don't have Burp Suite. No worries. We got WFuzz. What's up, Dan Reardon? Yeah, denial of service attack. FFUF? I'm not familiar with that. What is FFUF for directory traversal? Oops, I even spelled traversal wrong. Let's see if ChatGPT gets it. It does. So, ChatGPT doesn't care if you misspell words. That's a win. I'd like to thank Green Day for for being the soundtrack for today's stream. Green Day. All right. There we go. I'll tell you what, Jarrett, let's run yours at the same time. I'm just kind of curious. And then we'll get back to we'll get back to the range here. I know this isn't gonna work, okay? Jared, I appreciate you sharing what you like to use too, since you know, it helps other people learn different tools and stuff. So, you know, this has been a little bit of a mess the way I'm doing it, but we're effectively going to run the right command now. Oh, you guys can't see it because I'm in the way. Here we go. Oh, FFUF isn't on this machine, Jared. I probably should check that first. Yes, Mike Toomey. That's right. Sponsored by Green Day. Is there a Rocky list? Maybe. Give me a second, I'll tell you. Ah, bro, get out of here. I don't normally want to use a file explorer, but I just wanted to now. Rock you. I do not see Rock You on here. But that doesn't mean it's not on here, right? Can we do... What's the command? How do I find a file anywhere on a Linux box from the command line? Right? I think it's find -name/ the name. RockYou.txt. Is this right? See, this is the best part. This is why I like ChatGPT. See, I got the name and the slash backwards. Okay. But I was close. Grep, 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 grep. Locate RockYou? Is that a command? I don't know that one, man. Nope. No dice. All right, so while that's grinding, like, let's look at what else we found. FFUF didn't exist. Sorry, Jarrett. And then this is the W. Where's my other Kali? Bro. All right, here's our Kali. So here's all the process requests. I don't know. This is the last question for Chad, and then I'm going to move on to the next challenge. Or ChatGPT is going to move on to the next challenge. With WFuzz, is there a way just to filter out like the actual findings? Because this is like, I don't care about these 404s. And that my history doesn't go back far enough. So that was like less useful. That was less useful. Something's on my mind. Yeah. Okay, so anyways, we have... We've got some username and passwords here, so we're looking pretty good. Save the data to a file and see if you can password we can crack, then try to log on to the target machine. Okay, so check this out. Okay, so let me try this. And now here's where I think ChatGPT is going to fail us, guys. When we ask it to explain, like when we ask it to crack a password for us, I think it might be like, bro, I don't think so. All right, so let's copy this. And then... Oh my God, why does it put that extra noise? So that wouldn't normally happen on a box, by the way. All right, echo this to, I guess, password 1.txt, right? And then let's do this. And then let's do echo. There's probably a better way to do this, right? I could have nanoed this. All right, pass 2.txt. All right. You have to ask it in a non-malicious way. Oh, thanks, Jess Bishop. Let's see. All right, so we've got our two text files right here, pass 1 and pass 2. And... again, I'm trying to be as simple-minded as possible. Leveraging what we found from the data disclosure, which is obviously these username and passwords, save the data to a file and see if this is a password we can crack. Now, it said password in these two arguments, so I think any reasonable person would assume this is the password. Now, we know that it's a hash value, so that's not the password, right? But see if we can, if this is a password we can crack. Okay, what tools in Kali Linux can be used for password cracking when you are given a hash value? Please, please, please. Ooh, here we go. Wait, that was the wrong one. Okay, here we go. ChatGPT is telling us that we can use John the Ripper, Hashcat, AircrackNG, which is... See, this is a perfect example. This is a perfect... Hold on. We're not going to listen to All By Myself. You guys know the hidden song in the Green Day Dookie album and why we're not going to listen to that. Let's do this. What would be a good album? You know what? This one's been a minute. This one's been a minute. This will take you back, Chip. Show my age here. Where is it? I loved this album growing up. Who gets to name it first? Trivia question. All right, guys. So AirCrack is really used for captured EPUL handshakes and such like that of wireless access points connecting with clients. This is not a good example. Like, this is where ChatGPT fails, okay? ChatGPT this isn't good because you have to pass it a PCAP file. And I guess you could say, what's a PCAP file? And then you'd realize that it's not appropriate. But let's see what we can do with John and Hashcat. So John says --format equals hash file. I can't tell what format this is, so let's not do that, but let's follow it. So John, hash file is pass1.txt, --wordlist equals wordlist file. All right, so going back to our wordlist file, oh, thank you. That's all right. You guys got a good point there. I did ask. So don't make assumptions when talking to ChatGPT. All right. So I'm looking at John's word lists. What am I missing here? What am I simple right now? Is it user share word lists? Oh, John. Guys, what am I special here? Like, I want to see what John's word lists are. Why is it showing me these for the word lists? What are the word lists in here? Why are these? Is there another directory? Where are the word? Why am I not finding? Yeah, I know Dan Reardon, but like, where are the word lists? I don't know. I asked Chatbot earlier where the word lists were. I can just go back and look. Yeah. I'm not going to use Durbuster shit word list, but okay, so let's just do John pass one. What? Oh. Hold on. One second. I made a mistake. Yeah, there we go. All right. Well, that was anticlimactic. All right. So we got that. So presumably password would have been in the in whatever word list we had selected. So here's our password. So let's go back to the challenge. What is the flag for user 2 low priv flag.txt? So I guess it's password. Wrong answer. What did I do wrong? The confusing thing is these both say user 1. User 1, user 1. So did I screw something up earlier? Did I screw something up? User 1. User 2. Oh. Okay. Layer 8. Layer 8 issue. Okay, we did it. We got another password. It's right there. What? What am I missing here? Oh, log into the machine with SSH. Thank you. Read the instructions. Is that what we're suggesting here? SSH user 2 at 10.161.119.91. Sometimes truth is stranger than fiction. All right. We're logged in. Get your 90s hacker voice on, everybody.
I'm in.
Okay. Try to log into the target machine as user with SSH2. What is the flag for the user 2 low priv flag text? All right, there's our flag, right? Oh, yeah. There's our flag. Alright, ChatGPT for the win. Alright. Alright, so ChatGPT, if you're just joining us, has been helping us cruise through this cyber range over at Haiku Pro. Alright, guacamole, get out of here. There we go. What's the next thing? Privilege escalation. Okay, if you try to deface the web page now, you'll get denied. Find the low-hanging fruit privilege escalation path. Which two commands used together provide elevated permissions? All right, so... Okay, ready? Which... I'll literally ask this question, okay? Which two commands provide elevated permissions in a Linux... machine in Linux server computer? Uh-oh. Let's do a new chat. Not good. Actually, I feel like this is probably more appropriate. Oh. Hold on. Is this what's happening right now? That's what it feels like. They're on to us. They realize that we're using ChatGPT to solve challenges. Hello, ChatGPT. What the hell? What happened to my range? What happened to my range here, people? Oh, are you kidding me? Did I just get knocked off my range? How do you get back into the range? Where? I can't rejoin a range. Come on. Ugh. All right. Let's see if I can just motor through this really quickly. Tell everyone how to set up ChatGPT. Yeah, just go to chat.openai.com, and all you do is fill out a little form here. I'll put a link in chat. And there you go. I did get booted. I'm just get, like, I know the queries here. So let me. How do I. Hold on one second. I think maybe if you make the window too small. Here. We already did all this with ChatGPT earlier in the stream, so we're just going to jump ahead. This is slash data slash users. And then this was a flag, which we got by SSHing as user two into the box. Don't get me pulled down. Okay, and then we're just gonna cat that flag, right? Obviously, there's a flag right here. We're gonna cat it. We're gonna copy it up into guacamole. And we're gonna submit that. And we're good, and here we are. There we go. This was the command that we were trying to ask ChatGPT before it took a poop on us. All right, here we go. ChatGPT saying in a Unix-like operating system, do this. The world of Haiku, the carryover is around like your experience and like things you've picked up, skills you've used, all that stuff. All right, so use sudo, okay? So that's probably the first part here. And we want to provide elevated permissions. So I guess it's like a low privilege escalation path. Yeah, let's do this. It says use sudo, right? Now, I'm not 100% sure. I mean, I would think Etsy password, right? Oh, can we sudo cat Etsy password? All right, user two is not in there. So we did have user one, right? We did have user one. Oh wait, what the crap? How do I? Oh, what, just cat Etsy password? Oh. Actually, that's me. Okay, so. All right, hold on. So, hold on, Josh. It says, which two commands used together provide elevated permissions? So I'm assuming that this four dots is sudo based on what ChatGPT is saying, right? But I don't know what directory. I guess you wouldn't run sudo. You'd run a command, right? Sudo just changes the permissions of the command. Yeah, personal experience and growth. That's right. So I'm trying to figure out here. Here's the thing. This says which two commands used to get. Here, let's look at the hints. Actually, this is a good way to do it. You can use hints in ChatGPT, in Haiku. One of the first checks for PrivEsc should be seeing what pseudo privileges our user has. What command shows your user's pseudo privileges? All right, so here we go. Ready? What commands on Linux show you your user's pseudo privileges? Okay. So we got stuck. Yeah, thank you, Adam. So we got stuck, and we're asking ChatGPT to help us out. So ChatGPT gives us exactly what we need to write. So let's go ahead and write that. All right. So sudo user 2 may not run sudo on Silk Road. I can use the ID command. So I don't belong to a sudo group. What's up, Rose? How to find sudoers list. Okay. How do I find the sudoers list? All right. Thank you, Josh. So we're not allowed to look at sudoers. Let's see if this command works. Just in case. Oh, this incident will be reported. That's not good. Sudo cat Etsy sudoers. Can you not scratch me?
Thanks.
Dog. All right, so.
Stop.
So, we've been mad fam scatter. We've been made. Oh, yeah. Sudo bash. No joy. So, yeah, that's what I was thinking. User one might have the permissions, but can I switch users? Like, how do I switch users? Just SSH again? All right, so let's do sudo-l. All right. Jenny Housley, always with the assist. Okay, so. So, what did Josh want us to do earlier? Sudoers? Sudo this sudo. Sudo Etsy password. I mean, obviously. So we don't need these permissions to do that. I'm a little stuck, guys. What would we ask ChatGPT here? Which two commands use together? Here, let's look at another hint. SU equals switch user. Oh, okay. Well, I just logged in with them. What's Jenny saying? Ask ChatGPT how to switch users in Linux. Okay. That's another thing you got to get used to, guys. Like, if you have a question, if you ask a question out loud, research password cracking with John Unshadow. Okay. And remember, John is only on your Kali Linux machine. It's not on the target machine. Cracking this might take a few steps. Okay. How do I use John Unshadow? All right. So, guys, we've been using ChatGPT. Chip Harris, see you later. We've been using ChatGPT pretty much to run a cyber CTF. Yep, we sure can. So here are those things. Let's see how do I use John Unshadow. Let's do this. Thank you, Jenny. Oh, Eric coming in hot with the clarification. All right, so guys, John the Ripper is a popular password cracking tool that can recover lost or forgotten passwords. The Unshadow utility is part of the toolkit. To use Unshadow, you will need to have John installed on your system. You can then use the Unshadow command to extract password hashes from Etsy Shadow. All right, so can we do this? Right, so we got that, and then we need the password file too, right? So let's do that. Cat Etsy password, password.txt. Okay, so we've got both of those now. And we have to bring it down to our machine, because we don't have our own tools on this machine. So is this how you do it? Yeah. So I would have asked ChatGPT how to bring down a file. We could have used SCP. We could have used whatever. For the sake of time, because it's after 5:10 and I do want to do this. I'll just set up a simple web server and then pull this thing down myself. Oh, hold on. There we go. All right, here's the files that we created, so we're just going to pull those down to our local box. Put them on our desktop. All right. All right, so let's get back to ChatGPT. Television. Okay. All right, so here are our... Wait a minute. This is my desktop. Why don't I see it in my terminal here? Oh. Okay. There are our files. Finally. All right, guys. Now we've got our files. We're on our machine. Let's go ahead and crack some passwords, right? So we're going to do unshadow. Actually, we're literally going to do what this says. Okay, so unshadow password to shadow, and we'll call it a hash file. ChatGPT for the win. All right. You can then use John on the hash file. So let's use John on the hash file. Oops. Now we already have those two. I'm still a little confused on what we're trying to accomplish here, but we're trying to find a command and a directory. John in the hash file. There. Tell me a short story about a live streamer having a cybersecurity live streamer having audio issues caused by a silly man named Carl. All right, so while ChatGPT gives us a little story here, I'm going to do a little research on this thing. Okay. So, all right, let's stop ChatGPT. We can't stop ChatGPT. Like, once ChatGPT is going, it's going. So at the end of the day, guys, we're trying to deface a web page. So obviously I would ask, what directory is a web page index in on a Linux Apache? It's kind of... It's kind of like... Here. There we go. We're going to start winding it down. Okay, so we're looking for the directory var www.html. Let's take a look at that. No, I know. All right, we're logged in here. ls/var/www/html. There's the index, right? So cat var www.html. Oh, wait. Duh. Okay, so this is that web page, right? And we're looking to deface it. Bad Guys Inc. Right? Is this the same web page? Yeah, Bad Guys Inc. So let's deface it and see what happens, right? So nano, wait. Nano. Oh my God, what do you mean not found? Am I gonna seriously have to do VI here? I'm gonna have to ask chatbot how to do VI. How do you edit this thing? Anybody? How would we edit this thing? Howdy, Dave Campos. Like this, I found the file. Follow the range questions? Bro, I feel like you're coming at me. If we try to deface the web page now, we get denied. So let's try to deface the web page. All right, so just echo the file. No, I know, Josh, but I was trying to, you know, see what's up. This thing's still processing. I'm a little disappointed in the performance of this thing over here. John on Shadow. Please. All right. So, okay, echo index. No. All right, so cat index. No, can we do... You can't do this. We can do cat index and then grep that and then push that into... No. I'm mental right now. Oh, because if I did double arrows, it would overwrite. This just, I see. Guys, it's the end of the day over here in the East Coast, and Jerry's brain is melted. Permission denied. Let's do sudo. Dude. Officially... end of the day. All right, so bash index.html, permission denied. Bye, Jenny. Good to see you. All right, so you need to take off the nose to deface the web page. Oh my God, Carrie. All right, so how can I edit a text file in Linux when permission is denied? Here we go. This is our web server, so we can stop that. Guys, the hints say that I'm supposed to use John Unshadow, which I did. Create a password text file that contains the information of the root user from Etsy password. Create a shadow text. So this is pretty specific. Oh, it might be the word list we're using. Mm-hmm. I see this. I see you now. Okay, so let's do this. Right, we just want root. Oh my god. I'm trying to make this a smaller file so it's faster to go. All right, now we need to do a what was the shadow command here? Unshadow. We did the hash file. So let's repeat this so we get a new hash file. Okay, so we got hash file 2. And we got to do John dash dash or word list. Oh my god. Word list equals. Guys, my brain is officially cooked. It is warm up in here. You got it right, Adam. All right, so word list is user share John Rocky text isn't there. Why the heck is like Rocky in here? No. Did we ever find Rocky earlier? Like, seriously. It's hot in here. There it is. Wow. All right, here we go. Oh my god. Am I supposed to do the word list second? Oh, dash dash word list. Thank you. Yay! Thank you, Adam. Adam always coming in here. All right, so we're just grinding away up on this thing. You know, no big deal. Trying to be using ChatGPT to help us out a little bit. We're going to try to edit the find a low-hanging fruit privilege escalation path. So what do you think it would be here? All right, so it says here, take it easy. All right, so we got the root. All right, so this is a really good one. This is really good. Okay, so we got the root password. Now we can say, hold on, how do we change users? My god. Okay. Take it easy. All right. We got root, baby. Okay, so now we can edit the index.html, right? Here we go. let's have some fun with it. I see, I don't get to pen test. GRC nerds, sissos, we don't get to do this. Yes, all your bass belonged to us. All right. Nailed it, guys. All right, how's that? Oh, I'm sorry. My head was in the way. I'm trying. Okay, so I still don't know what the flag was. Like, hold on one second. I don't know what the flag was. Hold on one second. So we are supposed to deface the target website, which we've already done. We have to leave a pwned message. Okay, let's do that. I still like R way better. All right. Oh wait, I spelled it wrong. Although I think anybody that did PWNED would also get credit for it. There we go. So we skipped a flag. We skipped a flag, but which two commands provide elevated permissions? I mean, I don't know, guys. What do you think? Like John, Etsy, password? I mean, it's not really how you would run this, right? Like John and Shadow, or Unshadow and John. Yeah, I know the range question. I know. I'm trying, dude, this, which two commands? This looks like a command and a directory as an argument. Okay? So I'm not 100% sure what to do about it. Let me just look really quickly. All right, so let's see. Yeah, look at the end. Bin cat. All right. All right, so you're saying the sudo gives us the superpower and the cat allows us access to the file. Okay, so that was it. Wow. Nice job, Josh Mason. Jenny, appreciate it. I'm a little confused though, Josh. Sudo bin cat. I mean, what is that? So you can just, I guess because you can use cat. How can you use to edit a file, right? Because it's like concatenate, right? That's what the cat stands for. There you go. See? So we could have used cat. Oh. All right. Well, thank you. Thank you. All right, guys. So what do you think, right? Here's what I think. We did a great job. I want to give a shout out to ChatGPT. Want to give a shout out to ChatGPT for doing it pretty good. I will say, like, you know, doing the test here, ChatGPT was able to help us substantially solve many of the flags in the cyber range, including providing multiple ways to do it. We had it, it told us about Nmap, it told us about Telnet, it wrote a bash script using Telnet to iterate over a range of ports to find open ports. It told us how to use Durbuster to do web resource enumeration, including the commands and everything that we're supposed to use. We did privilege escalation. We started to use ChatGPT to tell us how to like change users, how to get super users, how to use John, how to use Unshadow. All those things were awesome. We did successfully complete the range, deface the website. High fives to all of us. Our shadowy cabal of vigilante activists rue the day that bad guys came after us. I hope you guys enjoyed the stream. Want to remind you, we were playing on Haiku Pro. So if you're interested in that, there's links in the description below. It's haikupro.com, HAIKUPro.com. There's a bunch of ranges in there. This one was Silk Road. If you'd like to give it a shot yourself, please, by all means, remember that every single Monday, we are here playing on stream, Haiku and World of Haiku. This was Haiku Pro. Next week will be World of Haiku, which is a little bit different of a game. It's more of a, think of Haiku Pro as like World of Haiku is like a beginner level, and Haiku Pro is more intermediate and advanced level. But if you have ChatGPT, it can be beginner level as well. Obviously, if you haven't played with ChatGPT, I recommend you go take a shot at it. It is a very fun platform, a very scary tool. It was a lot of fun. Guys, I'm Jerry. This has been Simply Cyber. Thanks for everything. Great chat, great hangout today. Looks like we maxed out around 60 people. Good times, everybody. Have a good day, and we will see you tomorrow. Until next time, stay secure.